r/AskReddit by Reddicle. Serious, people who have happened upon dead corpses randomly. What happened? On a drive to work early one morning, I came down a hill to see a vehicle off in a field to my right. It was upside down and on fire, so I immediately stopped and called 911. As I was running up to the vehicle, I could see the driver still strapped in. He wasn't moving or screaming, so I could only assume he was already dead. I couldn't get to him because of the fire. I really struggled with that for a while. That sucks, man. But you did what you could. It would be doubly tragic if you got injured or killed for a man who was already past saving. You stopped and got help. You did your part. This is a tricky thing to get over. I was the first person to arrive at the scene of a brutal traffic accident. The driver in the vehicle was still alive, although in the moment I thought they were dead. The car had flipped upside down and all I could see was a silhouette of a lifeless body illuminated by dim streetlights. It happened at night. All I could do was wait for the paramedics to arrive. They got the guy out and airlifted him. The whole thing happened about 150 feet from my front lawn. The next day there was a bunch of teenagers leaving flowers at the intersection because the kid had died at the hospital. I don't remember everything as it happened, and normally I have an almost photographic memory. I just recall bits and pieces. The whole thing ducked with me for years. I became more conscious behind the wheel and would stress out when needed to go on long trips. PTSD ducks with your mind, and it took years for me to come to terms with what I encountered. When I was living in San Francisco, there is a homeless person sprawled on the ground. I asked some passerby if we should call an ambulance, and the guy at the store we were near said the homeless person did this all the time to get tips. I got what I needed from down the street, and on my way back I saw him being zipped up in a body bag by some paramedics. Living in SF has made me so desensitized to these things, not without empathy. Just used to encountering dead or near dead homeless in the day to day. The event I was describing happened almost 10 years ago too. I moved out of San Francisco in 2012 when rent was skyrocketing and the homeless problem was getting exceedingly worse. I can't imagine what that city is like now. As a teenager in 1987, I found a dead prostitute on my first day of work at a McDonald's. She had hung herself on the tall fence surrounding our dumpster compactor area. I freaked and got my manager. I also saw hanging, so ducked up colon the tree. I saw the body was actually pretty short. His feet were only 6 inches off the ground. So the first thing I thought was like, oh my god, what a tall guy. Then the primal fear set in. I'll never forget that morning. I think that may be worse. The moment of thinking something that's not positive, but intriguing. I would assume this would give off some level of endorphins, only to be replaced with a duck ton of adrenaline when you click to what has happened. I imagine that jump from intrigue to fight or flight would be more jarring than resting neutral to fight or flight. I'm so sorry. Happened at my elementary school party back around 1998. We were having a party at this teacher's house with about 30 other kids and 4 other chaperones. There was a pool in the back that was about 8 feet deep. We were all jumping in and out of the pool and it was dark out. Eventually the teachers told us all to come inside because it was almost time to go home. As we're all getting out of the pool, there was still someone at the bottom and wasn't moving. One of the chaperones jumped in and grabbed him. He was already dead. The whole school had a memorial for him and it was all honestly just a horrible time. Something similar happened to my mom. A big group of kids swimming in a dam lake, and whilst they had adult supervision, there were a lot of them, so keeping track was obviously difficult and the water was muddy. My mom and a friend felt something tugging their legs and freaked out, so all the kids ran out of the water. Turns out one of the kids was caught in the reeds and couldn't swim up for air, so he was tugging for help. He drowned and nobody noticed he was missing until it was too late. She still feels horrible about it. Hole up, a party for students at a teacher's house. WTF. We had a corpse turn up in the woods behind my house. There was an older gentleman that would always chop firewood from tree falls out there. One day he was hiking around, saw what he thought was a weird rock, turned it over and it was a human skull. My house was right on the only access road, so when I came home from school there must have been like 60 cars out there, all Leos and paramedics. Crime scene unit, etc. Some guy who had schizophrenia went out into the woods. It was an older gentleman that had gone missing a few years prior. They think he died of exposure. and coyotes had gotten at the body because he was scattered around. In a retirement home, I walked into a room to an old man lying on the couch. I thought the old man was sleeping, so I shut the door. 2 hours later, we saw paramedics walk into his room. That really sucks, man. But don't beat yourself up about it. There was no way you could have known that he was dead, and all of us would do the same thing. I mean, it's not like he was going to get more dead. A guy at my university was walking to class with his earbuds in and his hood over his head. He walked right across train tracks, lost in thought, while other people were screaming at him that the train was coming. I was about 2 minutes behind and saw the immediate results of this guy not paying attention. It's a weird feeling. The matter of fact nature of seeing a dead person. It's not like anything else changes. The train stopped. The people who saw it were horrified, and the police came. But before the end of the week, no one at the school was even talking about it. This happened to someone I went to high school with almost word for word. Incredibly sad. There has been a ton of weird deaths around the smart train in my town, and I always wonder if it was this sort of situation or maybe someone trying to commit suicide. In my second year at university, my good friend at the time went missing for 2 days, and after getting the warden to come with me and check his room, we found him dead. He had committed suicide in the 2 days I hadn't seen him. What still haunts me is that my last message to him was, "Hey man, you still alive?" in a joking way. Safe to say I've never sent anyone a message like that again. Oh god, I can't imagine. I send jokey messages like that all the time. I really hope you don't hold that against yourself. I don't really speak about it much. Like, this is the first time I've spoken much about it since it happened. Sometimes I wonder why, but at the same time I know that in the months I got to know him, we had some great laughs, and I feel like I showed him some light in life. I just wish it was enough. Thank you for Silver. I used to work in hospice, and I was always the lucky employee to find patients dead. We know it's going to happen, but nobody wants to be the one to find a corpse. This one bothers me the most. We had a patient who regularly worked the night shift for 40 plus years and would go absolutely nuts at night due to dementia and sundowning. I checked the patient at 7 a.m. and he was sleeping, so I'll let him be. The night shift reported me that he had been sleeping for 3 hours. Turns out he was not sleeping. At 7:30 I came back with a breakfast tray, and it dawned on me that he had been dead the entire time. I found another patient face down on the floor with no pants right at 7 a.m. It was assumed that the patient stood up and had a heart attack, fell on their face and didn't get enough oxygen. It's safe to say that the night shift didn't do their job. They would sit at the nurse's station on their phones all night. Another patient passed away while looking at me, and I saw his life force fade from the body as his eyes rolled back and respiration stopped. I actually had to go home after that one because I passed out after realizing what happened right before my eyes. Edit. I no longer work in hospice as it was depressing and burning me out. My last hospice experience was taking care of my grandmother, and I wouldn't change it for the world. Working in hospice was one of the most humbling experiences. We always talk to the patient even when they are clearly in the hour of their death. They can hear you. Ensuring death with dignity is one of the most important life lessons that I learned. Now I work in a rehab, and it's good to see people get better and go home. Can't tell you how many times I've come upon an unresponsive patient at 7 a.m. in the hospital that was sleeping soundly all night before. Seeing the life out of someone must be shocking. Like a realization of a that's dead. As a teenager, I went on a walk through the green belt behind my house. The woods had a peculiar smell, but I was used to stumbling across dead animals on rare occasions, so I didn't think anything of it. Clambered over a log and looked down to find I'd stepped in her hair. She'd been left on the hidden side of the log wrapped in a tarp and was well into the process of decomposition. No lips, eyes, etc. Went home and called my mom in a fog of shock, and she called the police. They didn't really believe me and were super casual while they walked me out to the spot so I could show them where she was. Their demeanors changed the instant they saw her, and from there it was all a whirlwind. She was my age. Murdered and dumped after sex by one of my high school teachers. I testified as a witness to finding her. Never really understood why they needed that. He went to prison, but I think he might be out by now. I feel terrible for her family. It didn't traumatize me, but it gave me a lot to think about in regards to the value and shortness of life. I started saying I love you to my family members a lot more afterward. Not so fun fact. The prosecution didn't need you to do that, but if the jury heard what it was like for an innocent civilian to find a body, they're more likely to vote guilty. It shows that their actions have an impact on more than just the dead person. Now that definitely makes sense. Out of the entire experience, beyond the first hour after finding her, testifying was the worst part. While I was on the stand, the prosecution told me they wanted me to look at some photos. I remember just this all-encompassing bolt of fear that I'd have to look at her again, and my mom told me later that my face went as white as a sheet of paper. Luckily they were just photos of the crime scene, but I can imagine being a juror and sympathizing with that. It was the summer in between ending high school and starting college. Went to a local beach with a few friends and their girlfriends. It was overcast that day, so there really wasn't anyone else there. The water was pretty rough, and we were body surfing for most of the day. As we're surfing the waves, we see Coast Guard officers roaming around by the edge of the water. Soon enough, Coast Guard vehicles start driving on the beach near the water. We knew something was up. They told us we need to leave this stretch of beach immediately and don't be within a 3-4 mile radius of the area. Still a very odd request to me. Sure enough, as we begin walking back to the parking lot, we see something floating in the water. I thought it was an animal until one of my friends turned white at the sight of a water bloated man lying face down. Found out a few days later it was someone who drowned while parasailing. Absolutely tragic. Found a dead guy at the train station by where I used to live. Not sure what happened, but I thought he was just a drunk waiting for the train. He was sort of sitting with his head down. I tapped him in a lame attempt to wake him up, and got nothing. I shook him a little harder, and he just sort of slumped to the side, and when his head went back, his face was gray and his eyes were open but empty. Called the cops, who came and gave my statement. Another time was walking to lunch with a friend in New York City. A guy had jumped out of a window. Older buildings have windows that open, even 20 or 30 stories up. He nosedived, bounced hard off a cab and was flopped in the street while the cops put the sheet down. Blood everywhere. Meanwhile, the passers-by stood there with their phones out taking pictures. I am sorry you had to see that. That was just horrible. Meanwhile, the passers-by stood there with their phones out taking pictures. This. Why are people like this? In my junior year of high school, my best friend and I were skipping school and walking around the woods by Murphy Park in Park Forest, Chicago Heights. There was an older man sitting on a bench on the trail. Briefcase, suit, etc. He reached into the briefcase when he saw us, pulled out a revolver, shoved it in his mouth, and ended himself. My friend and I sat there and freaked before we ran to his house over on Dogwood and called the cops. I don't know the story. All I know is I have never forgotten that smell since then. Also, we didn't end up getting in trouble for skipping, so we had that going for us, which was nice. Probably thought seeing a guy kill himself was plenty of punishment. That guy must have been a grade A hole to decide the last thing he would do on earth was traumatize some kids. Back in 2010, I was on the train coming home from classes. When approaching the station, there was a loud bang and people started flooding off the train screaming and crying. I knew something bad had happened, but I didn't know what. The platform was sheer chaos and I cautiously walked up the platform to figure out what to do. That's when I saw him. A 6-7-year-old boy had been running with his grandfather to catch his train and let go of his grandfather's hand. He tripped and went between the train and platform, killing him instantly. All I could see were his legs, and his grandfather slumped over next to the body. I immediately went into shock and had to get on a bus to get back home. I remember seeing one of my classmates on the bus, and I must have been in some state as I vaguely recall the whole bus just looking at me as I told her what had happened. Really messed me up for a long time. Oh holy shit. That poor grandfather. How do you recover from seeing that? Can you, even, for that matter? Are you okay? I've had that grandfather in my thoughts to this day. It's one thing to see a death or dead body, it's another to see someone lose a loved one, let alone a child, right in front of you. There are no words to describe it. I wanted to reach out to the family and wanted to find out who he was, but by the time I could even read a news article about it, a few months had passed and I felt it would be disrespectful to pursue it further. It took a very long time to process. I was at the end of college and had to focus on my finals and eventually getting a job. It wasn't till about 5 years later, 4 years ago, that one of the local pro-life activists stuck a flyer in my mailbox with a photo of a dead child. They were disgustingly using photos of children killed in Middle Eastern conflicts to convey their demented agenda. That I completely broke down and realized I hadn't resolved issues with what had happened. Now, I think I have a handle on it, but that shit doesn't leave you. Gone are the days of morbid curiosity and being numb to violence in our world. In the end, I am very adamant on protecting children and vulnerable people. I've got fight back in me, and whenever anyone makes jokes about a tragedy, I easily call them out. Definitely have grown stronger because of it, but it's still a difficult subject to this day. I have been kayaking and found a man whose decomposition was at the burst stage. Another time I was part of the recovery of a scuba diver who had been lost inside a San Diego for about a month at approx 120 FSW. His mask came off and eyeballs fell out as he was pushed through to me. Lost inside a San Diego for about a month at approx 120 FSW. Can you explain what this means? Thanks for watching this Reddical video. Subscribe for the best Reddit videos straight to your feed.